I wanted to talk about the salt. Yesterday, Governor signed this bill that was a workaround for the salt. Salt is the state and local taxes. And you may remember back in 2017, what was the name of that bill? We'll talk about it. They implemented a bill that restricted the amount of deductions for the state and local deduction taxes to $10,000. It was a way to make the rich pay their fair share, so we were told. And since they've implemented it, those progressive states like Illinois have tried everything they can to find a way around it. Last year, there was a couple of other states had implemented a workaround, and the IRS had looked at it, analyzed it, and then gave their blessing. They said, yes, this is a way to get around it. And since then, many states have done that, and Illinois again did yesterday. So I wanted to talk about what salt is, because I don't think a lot of people understand how that works on their own taxes. You know, whenever you hear a limit of the deductions, everybody gets excited thinking that that's going to affect them and they're going to pay more taxes. Nobody wants to pay more taxes. It's my job that people only pay what they're supposed to pay and not more. And I think that's what happens. A lot of small business people, they pay too much in taxes. And it's, again, it's my job to help them limit what they have to pay the IRS legally. And there's a lot of legal ways, tax planning ways, to save money on your taxes. In Illinois now, they raised our taxes was 2%, was 3%, went up for a short time. I think it went up to 3.5% or 4%. Then it went back down. And now it went back up to 4.95%. So that's what Illinois people pay in state income taxes, 4.95%. The workaround involves people who run their own business, what they call the flow-through. We talked about this on Monday, what a flow-through S-corporation is and why it can help people save money. The state of Illinois used that flow-through mechanism to help people avoid limiting their state and local tax deductions. And we're going to talk about how they did that. So let's talk about what is salt and how it can work, you know, how it all works. So there's a good article here from March of 2021, although reading it, it reads as if it was much earlier than this year. But I think, again, it explains what it is, and I think it's worth reviewing. The state and local deduction allows taxpayers of high tax states to deduct local tax payments on their federal tax returns. It actually helps all people in, no matter high tax or low tax, although low tax states, it's not as prevalent there, and many states don't have property taxes, but they do have sales tax. And you can take one or the other. You can take sales tax or property tax, not both. Under the IRS statute. The tax plan signed by President Trump in 2017, called the Tax Cuts and Jobs Act, instituted a cap on the salt deduction. Starting with the 2018 tax year, the maximum salt deduction available was $10,000. Previously, there wasn't a limit. Let's take a closer look at what a reduced deduction has meant for residents of high tax states like Illinois. If you're concerned about impact of these changes, consider work with a financial advisor, because this is a financial advisor's pay, so they want to tell you, work with a financial advisor. But you should always work with a tax advisor, obviously, if you are paying a lot of taxes. Taxpayers who itemize their deductions, meaning they don't take the standard deduction, can deduct what they've paid in certain state and local taxes. This salt deduction, as it's called, state and local taxes, include property, income, and sales tax. More specifically, anyone who itemizes can deduct property taxes. Now remember, in the 2017 bill that passed, the tax bill, it raised the number, the standard deduction. And one of the trades where it was, we're going to raise the standard deduction, eliminate some itemized deductions, and make it so they're not necessary, and make your tax return easier. Because if I have to have all these deductions in order to get my numbers down, my taxable income, to get that number down, I needed to do an itemized return. That costs more money. That's much more complicated. If they give me a larger standard deduction, a standard deduction which I probably won't get that much even if I itemized, now I don't have to itemize. Reduces my tax preparation costs, right? And makes it easier, less complicated, much easier for me to understand. Most choose to deduct their income taxes because those payments generally exceed sales tax payments. Residents of states with high income taxes generally opt to deduct their state and local income taxes if they itemize. Residents of states with high sales tax, like Texas, Louisiana, because they don't have a property tax, and low and or non-existent income taxes generally opt to deduct their sales tax if they itemize. However, property taxes and income taxes, not sales taxes, are the primary drivers of the SALT deductions. So the reasoning goes that, and I think we're going to talk about it here, we're going to break it down about who pays, who gets this deduction. You know, does the regular American get this deduction? Do middle America gets this deduction? And we're going to get to that because I think it's important. And this is why states like Illinois are against it. Because who's paying for it? We, as I've been mentioning it over and over and over the last several weeks, is that they are demonizing, you know, three groups. One of those three groups is the millionaires and billionaires who don't pay their fair share. Well, guess what? That's who gets these deductions, right? So if we limited it to $10,000, who's going to pay more taxes? Many of them, millionaires and billionaires. They're the ones that are going to pay the most in taxes. Yet these states like Illinois are trying to limit that. They don't want them to pay more federal taxes. They want them to pay higher state taxes and property taxes. I mean, that kind of goes without saying because that's why we have such a high property taxes. So who uses SALT deductions? Not every American takes the state and local deduction. High income filers are much more likely to itemize and therefore more likely to take the SALT deduction. The higher your income, the more valuable tax deductions are to you in general because you are taxed at a higher rate, right? So if I can save more money on my income and I'm at a higher rate, I save more on taxes. When the deduction for state and local taxes, the federal government is effectively subsidizing high earners in high productivity states and cities. Any deduction the federal government offers is a subsidy because you're giving them a tax break. That's a subsidy. As you might expect, wealthy residents of wealthy states are most likely to pay state and local taxes. They also tend to have the highest average SALT deductions, according to the Tax Foundation. People with incomes over $100,000 receive more than 88% of SALT deduction benefits. Well, that makes sense. Those who stand to gain from deducting their property taxes tend to be those who have expensive homes in prospering communities. Filers who deduct their state and local income taxes tend to be in high earners in thriving states. States and cities with high income taxes also tend to be high opportunity states like California and New York, and I'd throw in Illinois. The deduction for why the SALT deduction matters. The deduction for state and local taxes has been around since 1913 when the U.S. first instituted our federal income taxes. Defenders of the SALT deduction, such as the National Governors Association, point out that the state and local income, real estate, and sales taxes are mandatory. Taxpayers can't get out of them. For the advocates of the deduction, eliminating it would therefore constitute a double tax. So I'm going to pay tax on it to the state, and then I'm going to pay tax on it again to the federal government. At the same time, the SALT deduction is one of the largest federal tax expenditures, along with the mortgage interest deduction. The non-taxation of employer-sponsored health benefits and pension benefits, preferable tax rates on capital gains, and the tax deferral of corporate profits earned abroad. The SALT deduction cost the federal government trillions in missed revenue opportunities. Now, I'm not one to say that missed revenue opportunities is costing the government, because otherwise every dollar that I put in my pocket and get to spend is a lost revenue opportunity for the government, right? They could take it all. And so I don't think, you know, just saying that somehow if I get to keep more, that the government, it costs the government money. I guess in the long run it does, but not in my mind. So who misses SALT deduction the most? According to 2016 report from the Tax Policy Center, taxpayers with incomes over $100,000 would have the largest tax increase, both in dollars and as a percentage of income. Eliminating the deduction entirely would raise taxes for about a quarter of the taxpayers, and reducing the deduction, as Congress is planning to do, would affect about half as many people. Filers with incomes over $500,000 are greatly affected, but their losses in deductions could also be offset by the decrease in the top federal income tax rate. But we're not talking about decreasing the federal income. That's what the trade-off was in 2017. We'll take this deduction, but we'll lower the rate on all of your income. So in the end, you'll pay more. And this is always the strategy, right? They give and take, and then they just take, right? So you already given this, SALT, we already gave that up, and in return we got a lower tax rate, but now they want to put the lower tax rate back up higher, right? And so they're fighting to get rid of SALT, say, well, then you should get rid of SALT. But so far, Congress hasn't done it. So I just wanted to point one more thing out. This is who, these are the states that benefit. So in Illinois, 32.34 of Illinois returns deducted state and local taxes paid in 2014. The average SALT deduction on those Illinois returns was $12,877. That's 2014. Our property taxes have gone up much at a very great rate over the last, since 2014. So I would suspect that number would be much higher now. Although now you're limited to $10,000.